begins to distract us. As soon as something happens, pride comes in, and then what? What's a thing wells up in us. Yes. Y'all hear what the Spirit is saying this morning? And I want to be clear. I do a pretty good job because, see, I cannot stand before you and teach it if I don't reach it. Yes. See, some of y'all get in situations and y'all just bow down to the devil. Yes. You ain't got a care in the world. Mm-hmm. But see, I don't roll like that. When I'm in a situation and I feel the arrows of darkness, I feel them just like you do. And sometimes the base gets rocked.
Yes, yes, yes.
See, certain arrows don't bother me.
Yes.
But then these arrows over the last month have been different.
Yes.
And they've been rocking the base.
Right.
And the application now, there's been some stuff trying to swell up.
Yes.
And I had to go into the sanctuary of God. Because I can't sit here and talk to you about this if I don't know how to fix it myself. I went into the sanctuary of God and the Spirit of God said to me, I don't care what you're looking at. You need to allow me, Jesus, to come forth. And when Jesus steps forth, it will be love stepping forth. When Jesus steps forth, you don't see your enemy the same way. When Jesus comes forth, you get peace over the situation. Stops the swelling. Mm. Mm. Time I slipped on black ice. And I'll never forget, no one was home at the house, and I knew I needed some ice. How many know if you ever have something that's where it's impact, you know you gotta get ice on it. If you can get the ice on it, you can stop the swelling.
Yeah.
Do I have a witness? How many of you ever hit your head? Right? And you know, once you got in the house, if you got some ice on it in time, there would be no swelling.
Amen.
See, that's what we got to do when we get into situations where pride is trying to apply itself to a base. Get in the sanctuary of God and stop the swelling. If you can stop the swelling, you'll continue the flow of God, and He'll line you up for the blessing.
Amen.
See, when we get out of the way, watch what God will do. That's what God is speaking to us going into this year. We have to be careful of the appetite of pride. It paralyzes you. It removes you from the glory of God. It removes you from the ability to hear God. And when you can't hear God, you're listening to the other voice. I don't want to be listening to the devil today.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If you look outside, what do we see going on in our world today? Because folks are listening. Why? Because they're all swelled up with pride.
Yeah.
How are you and I, called by His name, covered with the blood of Jesus, supposed to be of a sound mind, allowing pride to dominate us? I'm not telling you I can't relate, because I was battling every morning. The psalmist said that he was chasing every morning. I would wake up and say, God, I would be getting away with this. This ain't right. Then I recognize this is not the Spirit of the living God that's activated in here. Went into the sanctuary. And some of you right now, you're holding on to something, and it's very easy just to hand it over. That person that looks like, just hand them over.
Amen.
Hand them over.
Yes.
Because the God we serve is able.
Yes.
He is able.
Yes.
No weapon formed against the church of God shall prosper.
Yes.
He will make thine enemies as a footstool. Get out of the way. Glory, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Glory to you, thank you, Jesus.
The swelling takes away our ability to reverence God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Proverbs 8:13, don't turn here. Look what it says. The fear of the Lord is to hate evil, pride, and arrogance, and the evil way. The fear of the Lord, the reverence of the Lord. We can't lose our reverence for God. The swelling takes away our ability to reverence God. The swelling now will cause our words to lead us to destruction rather than life. Psalms 59:12, it says, for the sin of their mouth and the words of their lips, let them even be taken in their pride. The swelling now leads us to verbalize destruction.
Yes, yes.
When you get into the sanctuary, you're going to listen to the voice of truth. And when you listen to the voice of truth, you activate life. You activate blessings.
Yes.
You activate trust. How many of you know you got to be patient if you're going to follow Jesus Christ?
Amen.
You better hurry up and learn that he don't move on your time, but he's on time.
Yes.
He don't move when you want him to, but he's always right on time.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then finally, the swelling will always lead to strife. Swelling, pride, the application, the base. The swelling leads to strife every time. Proverbs 13:10. But pride comes, by pride comes nothing but strife. The other day, me and my wife, these are the best years of my life. The other day we had a little disagreement. And I left the house. And I said, no, Devil, you're fine.
Right.
So you got to stop the swelling.
Yes, yes.
No. We walk by faith and not by sight. Satan kicked out Jesus